Hi everyone. Today I wanted to talk about the Planetfall series by Emma Newman. I've been really wanting to film a video about this series since I started it, but it kept coming out with more books and I finally caught up, so I thought this was an appropriate time to do so. There are currently 4 books in the series, being Planetfall, After Atlas, Before Mars, and Atlas Alone. Now, if you aren't into sci-fi and you still clicked on this video, I hope you haven't clicked away yet, because yes, these do seem like sci-fi novels, because they are sci-fi. But I feel like if you are wary of sci-fi, not generally finding yourself to be interested in sci-fi, but you're like willing to take a chance, I think that this would be a great series to do that with, because I think that these are a lot more accessible than a lot of sci-fi novels. I feel like it's condescending to say that they're doing more than a lot of other sci-fi novels, but I think that they have a versatility to them that makes them really appealing and would make them very appealing to a lot of different kinds of readers. So in case you're unaware of the series, I think that this is an extremely fun, fast-paced series, but still with a lot of juicy plot and extreme character depth. I think more than just sci-fi novels, these are mystery novels. And more than mystery novels, I think they're really character-focused mystery novels. The protagonist is always the heart of the story, and I feel like you get a really great deep dive into their personality, their history. There's a lot of emotional depth, there's a lot of growth. I think that what Emma Newman does is remarkable because she does all of that, but it never feels stuffy, it never feels forced, and they maintain like a snappiness to the writing, a really quick pace, compelling plots, while not ever sacrificing that character depth, which means these books work really, really well for me. I think of them as like light sci-fi in that the sci-fi elements, the space travel and technological elements, they're described well enough that you understand their purpose in the story and generally how they function, but you're not getting lost in the minutia of how they were invented and integrated into society and lots of science stuff. That also doesn't tend to appeal to me as much. So they're light sci-fi novels, complex characters. They deal with a wide variety of complex themes, doing that thing that I love about sci-fi, tackling like what it means to be human and our place in humanity and how we relate to each other. So major themes are what it means to be human, the dangers of capitalism, the precarity of democracy, trauma, abandonment, parenthood, autonomy, and mental health. I think those are kind of the general main overarching themes that appear in most, if not all, of these novels. We have predominantly female protagonists, although After Atlas does have a male protagonist. There are queer characters on the page. There is a character who is coded to be asexual, even though I don't think that that term is actually used. I think that is pretty clear on the page. Mental health in a variety of ways are addressed, such as postpartum depression, anxiety, and trauma, and how to kind of recover from trauma or not. And the other thing that I really love about these books are their endings. I feel like Emma Newman always ends her books on what another writer would take to be like a really climactic moment, but Emma Newman kind of pulls back and always leaves the reader wanting more, leaves the reader with some questions, and kind of leaves on a cliffhanger that makes you really want to go into the next one. It can be frustrating for some people, that ambiguity, but I really enjoy it because it doesn't feel like she's trying to spell everything out for you or wrap everything into a tidy bow, because this is not a tidy story. That just wouldn't feel right with these books. So what are these books actually about? I'm going to talk about them really briefly one by one. According to, I think, Emma Newman and the publishers, these are meant to be standalone. I don't agree with that assessment, but I will get to that. So starting with Planetfall, and don't worry, there will be no spoilers. I'm only getting a hint of like what the story is actually about, because of course I would encourage you to actually read them for yourself, but I want to give you enough of a taste so you can see where you might want to start with these books and whether or not the series will appeal to you as a whole. Planetfall is the first novel in the series. It follows a colony on another planet. I know that sounds really intensely sci-fi, but I don't think this story is lacking in any of those human elements that I was talking about earlier. This colony followed a prophet named Li Su Mi. She claimed that she knew of a place that revealed humanity's purpose in the cosmos, basically. She had followers that went on this interstellar journey with her to kind of find the answers of the universe. But now they're on the colony. Now what? They've been there for a long time when, seemingly out of nowhere, a person begins to approach the colony. And where did this person come from? Because there shouldn't be any other people on this planet, because they are theoretically the original colonizers. So that's kind of the catalyzing moment, and the overarching mystery that begins with this book is how did this person get there? Who are they? And What do they want? But it's much more about, like, people living in the colony and living in this communal space. There's an inherent claustrophobia to the novel because our protagonist, Ren, has many secrets. One being about her mental health and trying to conceal that from other people, to the point where she even conceals it from the reader, the extent of it, so I won't go any further than that, but it's I think really skillfully done. Ren, the protagonist, is also dealing with a lot of guilt because she left family behind on Earth when she left, but she was so devoted to Lisumi and even, like, in love with her, to the point that she does feel like guilt, but also, you know, she made that choice. This, to me, is the most, like, standalone of the novels because it does tell a pretty complete story. The characters are, being on a different planet, removed from the other characters in later novels, and so I think that this is a relatively self-contained story. You could start and end here, and I think be pretty content. In fact, that's kind of where I was at the beginning. I read this. I didn't immediately jump into After Atlas because I was content with this story, and I left so much time in between this and After Atlas that I actually read it again so that I'd be more acclimated for After Atlas because I had assumed that they were more connected than they were, but they're really not that connected. I overall enjoy this book. I do think it's probably one of the more conventional of the sci-fi stories in the series. I think it gets better from here, but I do really enjoy this book. Oh, another thing that I want to mention really quick is that Emma Newman does some really fascinating things with the 3D printing that I hadn't ever thought of before, because their whole society functions off of 3D printing and things being printed from kind of, you know, base materials. Because how do they get food? How do they get supplies? They didn't bring, you know, like a lifetime's worth of supplies with them to this planet. They have to create things from something, and so 3D printing is the technical solution in the book. It doesn't get more technical than that, but I thought that that was a neat adaptation of technology that already exists, just kind of expanded out for other uses in the future, potentially. So next is After Atlas, my favorite of the series. This takes place on Earth, and we're focusing on people that were left behind by the people that went on this interstellar journey. Particularly one person, Carlos, who was dealing with a lot of feelings of abandonment because his mother was one of the people that went on the ship. He, in his adult life, is essentially a slave. And this is where we get introduced to what Earth has become, and maybe why people wanted to leave it, because essentially democracy in this world no longer exists, and corporations and the government have sort of merged into singular entities. So the world is literally ruled by capitalism. And in order to pay down their debts, some people have to become slaves, such as Carlos. He is a police detective and he is solving a mystery in this book, but he's also completely under the control of corporations. And you see just how damaging this kind of society is. But at the heart of this is a really fascinating mystery story. I think that the payoff of the mystery itself is really, really earned. In my perspective, Carlos is the most well-developed of the characters, the protagonists in these books. You get a really deep dive into his past and dealing very deeply with, like, trauma and betrayal, feelings of neglect. I think it's a very emotionally impactful novel, and it also has one of the craziest endings of any book that I've ever read. So I really, really, truly loved After Atlas. Thought this was a thrilling novel. Poses a lot of interesting questions about capitalism and the precarity of democracy, like I said earlier, and I think it's really well done. I really, really enjoyed this book. And this is the book that makes me think that this series is not truly a series of standalone novels, because the ending of this book changes everything. And it is just, it's talked about directly in the subsequent novels, so if you didn't read this first, it would be spoiled for you. And I feel like it kind of follows a linear trajectory from here, so the subsequent two novels are directly impacted by what happens in this book. I don't really feel like they're standalone, but that is what they claim. From there, we go into Before Mars, which focuses on a woman who is working for one of these GovCorps. She has been hired by essentially the man who owns Mars and all of the rights to Mars. He wants her to go to Mars to paint the Martian landscape, but integrate elements of the landscape into the painting, like the actual Mars dust and rocks and stuff. She can also tenuously connect this to her career as a geologist, because she's both an artist and a geologist. Upon arriving on Mars, she finds a note in her hand that says that she cannot trust a certain person who's on Mars. But how could that note have gotten there? Because she just arrived. So she knows right away that it couldn't have been forged. It actually is in her own hands. So it immediately triggers this feeling of paranoia and claustrophobia in this colony, because she doesn't feel like she can trust anything, even her own memories. The mystery in this one was a little bit weaker to me, but I think that the character exploration is still just as rich, because our protagonist is dealing with a lot of other complicated feelings in terms of abandonment, particularly tied to her child, who she left behind on Earth. And so it's kind of the flip side of After Atlas, because we're seeing her perspective and how she doesn't feel that special feeling about motherhood that people talk about, like how being a mother changes your life and changes your whole perspective and your child is your everything. She doesn't really feel that, and grappling with her feelings of not actually feeling that guilty about it. So I think that like I said, there's still a lot of really rich character stuff. This definitely expands our understanding of the world, how the government / corporations operate. It does also address some of the consequences at the end of After Atlas. So if the cliffhanger hooked you into wanting to read the next one, you do have to wait a while to get there, but it gets there in the end. For me, that added an extra layer of tension because I knew that that was coming at some point. I just didn't know when it was going to hit the story and when those ripple effects would be felt. So I was kind of on the edge of my seat the entire book waiting for that to happen. But when it did happen, it was really interesting. It would be a big twist, I think, though, if you hadn't read After Atlas. It might feel like it came out of nowhere. And I think that some of the consequences and motivations behind that thing that I'm trying to be really vague about, I don't think that they would come across as much if you read Before Mars, Before After Atlas, if that makes sense. So, I don't know. I wouldn't recommend starting with this one, but I guess theoretically it could be read as a standalone. And that is where we get to the most recently released book, Atlas Alone, which I truly hope is not the last book in the series, because there are a lot of questions that have yet to be answered, and I think there are a lot of places the story could still go. And as far as I could find, I've not seen any news from publisher about there being more volumes, so I don't know. I hope there are. But this is where the series, as of, you know, March 2020, beginning of the coronavirus pandemic, there are only 4 of these books. Atlas Alone is a direct sequel to After Atlas. So if anyone is claiming to be that this is a standalone novel, they are lying or don't understand the plot of this book, because it deals directly with the after effects of After Atlas. We are following characters that were in After Atlas. So Carlos was the protagonist of After Atlas, and he had a close friend who had also gone through what they called hot housing, which was the kind of torture and conditioning that people who were slaves go through in order to be highly specialized at their jobs. That's why Carlos is a detective, is because he's been trained to like be super critical and over analytical. So he's been conditioned to be like the perfect detective. And the protagonist of this book is his friend, who has been conditioned to do like highly detailed data science. And she particularly is like, she worked in the entertainment industry analyzing data about consumers. I will say that it does take place a lot in like a virtual space, because it's addressing video games. The protagonist's name is Dee, and she gets an anonymous message from an entity that she doesn't know, inviting her to play this game that is reflecting a lot of her traumatic past really directly in ways that feel extremely invasive and don't seem possible. But she's playing through this game, and then the decisions that she makes in the game start having consequences in reality. So it's highly about games and gaming, but not in a way that I think is inaccessible for people that don't play games. That's all I really can say about this book. I did enjoy it. The ending of this was almost as shocking to me as the end of After Atlas, just because of the implications and just what happened. It was very surprising. I think that Emma Newman, does endings exceptionally well. They're one of my favorite things about her novels. I really enjoy these books. Like I said, I hope that there are more books to come, but if they're not, I'm pretty happy with the series as it is. I think it does interesting things with technology that don't feel like would be inaccessible for someone who doesn't like sci-fi. Like I said, the 3D printing stuff, but also there is a lot of like artificial intelligence and virtual reality things built in. People have, you know, microchips in their brains, and you have like a virtual assistant, you know, Siri, Alexa, whatever, in your AI, that has so seamlessly integrated into life that people are extremely reliant on them. And the parts that the AIs play in these people's lives is very interesting. And the way that the technology is just really integrated into life, I think, is also really well done. I think that's all I have to say about the Planetfall series. I would love to hear your thoughts on them, if you have read them, or if I have convinced you to at least try one. I think I'm a pretty strong believer in just reading them all linearly. If you're gonna read them all anyway, just read them in publication order. But if you're only gonna read one, I would read After Atlas. If you have any recommendations for me for books that are similar to the Planetfall series, I would love them, because I do like some harder sci-fi. I'm looking for things that are, you know, still really character focused and character driven, but still have interesting plots and writing that's really easy to dip into. That's essentially what I'm looking for in a sci-fi novel. So if you have suggestions, I would love them. And other than that, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.